As believers in Jesus, who is risen from the dead, his first disciple saw him in person, and we know him by faith. But the scriptures tell us to look unto Jesus, to keep our eyes on Jesus. He is the author and the finisher of our faith. Our faith is what is valuable in this world. And to keep our eyes on him. And the scripture said that we don't look at what we can see, but we look at what we can't see. So this morning, we are looking at something we can't see because it's not of the world. Jesus is separate from the world. He's different. He's other than. He's so much better. He created the world. He did it in love and in his character and in his integrity. So this morning, I just encourage you to look to what you can't see, to lift your eyes up from whatever it is that might be bogging you down or holding you back, or, you know, even if you're thinking about what the other person next to you is doing, just worship Jesus. One day we're all going to be in front of him, and there's not going to be anything coming out of our lips except, thank you, I worship you, Jesus, because we're going to be overwhelmed by his beauty. So this morning, that beauty is right here, so I just encourage you this morning to walk in that.
Mira, si tiene un paper, yo quiero ahí.
We have some words, maybe?
La pastora.
That wouldn't
Las
be good.
Cositas que tiene el staple.
Anybody have a testimony this morning? Anything God has done for you at all this whole week long? Anything good the Lord has done?
I'd like to say that one can become born again. And born again, and born still again.
Amen. Amen. The revelation of
and
Jesus.
That's where I'm at.
Okay. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
That's a glorious Amen. Place. That's a glorious place. Anybody Amen. Else? Did anybody have food to eat today, this week? Did anybody have food to eat this? Did anybody have running clean water at your house? Did anybody have that? Did anybody have someone speak to you in kindness anytime this week? To speak to you and acknowledge you as a human being. Amen. So we are worshipful of God because every good thing comes from him. Amen. Every good gift comes down from our Father.
Amen.
Oh, I remember before Christmas, Miss Mary Lou, suggested that we read the book of Luke during the holidays. And I went home and forgot, she said, Luke, and I started in another book. And I have been reading my Bible daily,
Amen.
Every day.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Yeah, because we cannot look to what we don't see unless we're reading something that's talking about a whole different world
Amen.
And a whole different kingdom.
Amen.
So praise the
Amen.
Lord. I just pray that we all get more and more hungry for his word.
I agree with what she said. I can be close to the Lord and feel God's blessing and peace and all that, and I can fall away and, you know, have money problems and sickness and things like that, and it brings me back to God and Jesus, and life gets better. And so I agree, we can fall away and be born again, brought back, and maybe that's God's way of helping us along.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. So how many of you are ready just to rejoice before the King of Kings? You know the victory is already won. Any victory you're looking for, it's already been done in Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
gives us hands and feet. Worthy of all of our worship, all of our praise this morning.
Thank you. Hallelujah, Lord, fight Jesus,
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus,
Hallelujah.